So, EA's press conference is finished. And they showed a lot of sequels. No new IPs at all, but it doesn't matter to me. Or, well, they showed one special game at the entire start of the event, which is called Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. Yes, Plants vs. Zombies from your mobile phones, but this time it was actually an action shooter. It really looked nice, very fun to play. It will only be out for Xbox One and Xbox 360, which is kind of odd, so why wouldn't it be for PlayStation 4 or PC? Or perhaps they didn't just tell because of Microsoft. You know, Microsoft deals money. What was it all about? You take just a plant, just like in Plants vs. Zombies, a cactus or a peanut shooter or, well, whatever. And you take on waves and waves of zombies, which are like the Black Ops zombie modes. But it looked, cartoonish, fun, very fun to play. The boss fights in particular were very funny. other than that, not a lot of new, very, very new titles have been shown. There was a very small teaser for Star Wars Battlefront, and I love that. Damn, I'm so looking forward to it. It's going to be so terrific. But it's not going to be out this year. It's going to be for 2014. DICE, the creators of Battlefield, are developing it, and I'm very looking forward to it, as I've said before. Other than that, Dragon Age 3 Inquisition also got a new trailer. The developers at BioWare told us that it will be for next gen and current gen, and it will be entirely open world, but it will only be for fall 2014, not this year. It was a bit unexpected. I thought it was in development for a long time now, but maybe they just need more time, or they're afraid for The Witcher, who knows. Need for Speed Rivals also saw some footage, the next gen footage. It really looked like a lot of fun. Ghost Games, the new developer, seemed like a very capable developer for it. And it's once again one persistent world, and you can just play the single player game and just meet up with multiplayer opponent and all that in just one seamless world. Really like that. It's something that we will see in a lot of driving games or open world games now, I think. The Crew in Ubisoft, from Ubisoft, also features that, and the Drive Club game from Sony will also have something similar, so it's something here to stay, I guess. Other than that, well, EA Sports also came up with their new Ignite engine. They talked about FIFA 14, Madden 25, and also, finally, a new NBA Live title, NBA Live 14. It's finally returning, and, well, we saw one player, well, one NPC playing basketball, but it looked very, very impressive. Not really a lot of gameplay other than that, but let's just hope it finally comes back to us. UFC was also there. Formerly, it was at THQ, but since THQ went bankrupt, EA bought their rights to create games. And, well, they showed a little bit of the game. They had some fighters on stage talking about it. And, well, what the heck can I say? It's a new UFC with the EA Ignite engine. And if you were like UFC before, I do think that you will like it now as well. Other than those games, well, the only other game was Battlefield 4. the commander mode, the 64 multiplayer mode has been shown. It looked very impressive. A lot more tactic than in Call of Duty, just like before, but now it's even more impressive just to see how the commander can rank everyone. And well, everyone working together was just incredible. It was played with 64 players live on stage, and I'm really much looking forward to that game, other than, well, Call of Duty or another military shooter, just because of the fact that it looked awesome, destruction was awesome, and online, once again, it will be awesome. And well, that was about it for the EA conference. Oh, Peggle 2 was also announced. Yeah, they said that for like 2 3 seconds, and then poof, it was a new game. Oh well. And well, I was quite happy with it. It was a lot better than last year. Of course, not a lot of very new titles were shown, but in the end though, they did leave with one small surprise or big surprise, and that's Mirror's Edge 2. DICE is finally developing it. Once again, it will be with Fate and with free running, a lot of free running. It will be for the next gen titles. No release date yet. They did not show that. But I have trust in DICE that they will bring the game that we are looking all so forward to it to next gen in a capable form. With multiplayer, without multiplayer, no idea yet, but we'll just have to wait and see for that. This was the EA press conference, and thank you for watching. Eagle out.